Hi students, let's continue with the types of artificial intelligent agents. In the previous video, I explained about the simple reflex agents and the model-based reflex agents. Now, let me explain you the next type of artificial intelligent agent, that is a goal-based agent. So, in here, the name in saying that based on the goal, the agent is working. Let's see what is this. So here the goal-based agent focus only on reaching the goal set. So that I'm saying, the name itself is saying you have to work on a particular concept. Here that goal-based agent focus only on reaching the goal set. And hence the decision took by the agent is based on how far it is currently from their goal or desired state. If you want to reach to that, say suppose in the self-driving car, you just set a location of where you want to be reached. You just put a goal, means I want to reach that destination. So to reaching that goal set, this goal based agent, what it is doing, it taking the decisions to took by up the agent based on how far it is currently and from their goal and or desired state at present, at what state I am having, okay, how much speed I have to go, and based on seeing the environmental conditions, whatever the environments means, the traffic rules and the traffic that is there and the sensors and the GPRS, everything it has to be observed and it has to reach that desired state. So in that cases you can go for the goal based agents. Their every action is intent to minimize the distance from the goal. So this agent is, this goal based agent is more flexible, and the agent develops its decision making skills by choosing the right from the various options available. So this is an opportunity, this is one of the most excellent feature, because the artificial intelligence is able to find out, it's taking its own decisions just like a human. Did you observe this? So this agent, this goal-based agent is more flexible. Why I'm saying it is more flexible? Here it develops its decision-making and skills by choosing the right from the various options that are available. In the GPRS also, how we are finding out, okay, different routes are there. But our car will be taken to only one to specific location because the GPRS is checking all the different conditions. It's choosing the right path from the various options available. Means it has to check how much distance we have to go. If you go in one direction, how many kilometers? If you go in another direction, how many kilometers? Is there any traffic here? Is there any traffic here? It is observing, it checks all the directions. In that, it by choosing all the various options, it will select one decision to reach the final path. There's a goal-based agents. So let me explain you with this example. So here you can see. So in all the examples, I'm just taking the, I'm keeping in mind the artificial intelligence is a self-driving car. So here the environment is there, that environment percepts to the sensors. Now the sensors, what the world is like now. So these sensors can be sensed with the state of that particular, the car, and how the world evolves, means how many options that we are having and what my actions do, what I can do. So to reach the desired goal, what can I do? That everything will be sensed by the word, the world sensors. Now that will be sent to what it will be like if I do action A. So it has to take a decision. So it is checking, okay, if I select one path, what will be the action it takes place? If I take the another path, what will be the desired solution that I will get? So it is just decision making. It's just doing decision making, the artificial intelligence. So what it will be like if I do some action A? After that, finally, if it gets that action, what action I should do now? Okay, I want to reach to that particular action. So what action I should do now? That will be based on the desired goal that you have to set. This is a goal-based agent. So based on that goals, that signals will be sent to the actuators. Now the actuators will perform an action and that result will be seen on the environment. So this is a goal-based environment. And the next goal-based agents, next type of artificial intelligent agent is a utility-based agent. Utility. So these agents are similar to the goal-based agents. I'm saying that it is similar to goal-based agent. Why I'm saying it's similar to? Because it is having the features of that goal-based agents. Means based on the desired, if an agent is set with a particular goal, it will reach through that goal by with the help of decision making and by selecting the different options. Okay, so but it provide an extra component. So along with this goal-based agent, it can provide an extra component of utility measurement, which makes them different by providing a measures of success at a given state. So the only difference here is, so you know the goal-based agent. So to that goal-based agent, one extra component will be added. That is the utility measurement. So what's the use of this utility measurement? It measure it, which makes them different by providing a measures of success at a given state. So utility-based agent act based on not only on goals, but also the best way to achieve the goals. So this is the main important here, the main difference between the goal-based and the agents. So whereas in the goal-based agent, it reaches to the particular goal, but whereas in utility-based agent, it acts based on not only the goals, but also the best way to achieve the goals. The utility-based agent is useful when there are multiple possible alternatives and an agent has to choose. So whenever you are in front of your eyes, if you are seeing different options, so in that you have to select the best option to achieve the goal. Suppose if you passed your 10th class and you, okay, after passing that 10th class, what subject I need to be take? In front of your eyes, you are having multiple possible alternatives. One is for medical, one is for engineering, and one is for other art and crafts. So different options here, alternatives will be there. So in that, you need to take the best way to achieve the goal. That is because of this utility based agent. So here this agent has to choose in order to perform the best action. The utility function maps each state to a real number to check how efficiently each action achieves the goal. So how this utility function will work? The utility function maps each state, whatever the present state that is having, so to a real number to check how efficiently each action achieves the goal. So let's see in this diagram. The environment perceives the sensors. Now the sensors is what the world is like now. So at that state of that agent and how the world evolves and what any actions that it can do, that everything based on all those three concepts, now the what the world is like now can be decided. And that after the next step, it will think what it will be like if I do action A. Suppose this is the goal based. Okay, in the goal based, we have to check what it will be like if I do the goal action. Okay, I selected the one of the particular action A. Now, what this utility function will do, the utility based system, based on this utility based system, which is having the utility function, it's how happy I will be in such a state. So here I'm checking one more option. So if I select that path, that is action A, is I'm happy or not? So that is the best path you are selecting. If you are selecting the best path, means you will obviously you will happy. So how happy I will be in such state. So okay, I'm happy. I'm very much happy in that state. So then I'll do action. So that action will be sent to the actuators. Now the actuator will perform that action and the result will be seen on the environment. So this is a utility based. And the last one is the learning agent. Okay. Learning agent. So what this learning agent is? Learning agent, it can learn from its past experience. So everyone will learn a lesson from their past experience only. In the same way, the artificial intelligence is also, the learning agent is also can learn from its past experience, or it has the learning capabilities also. Maybe it has the learning capabilities, or it may learn the lesson from the past. Even I am also, let me take me. Okay, I learn from the past. Okay, I have to do some work, or I can have the learning capabilities in my, so that I'm able to tell the subject. Okay, with maybe I'm having the learning capability to explain this artificial intelligence, or maybe with the help of the past experience, maybe I taught already artificial intelligence. So with that knowledge, I'm able to speak to you. I'm able to explain to you. Or I suppose I don't have any past experience. I don't know artificial intelligence. At present, I'm having a learning capabilities. At present, I'm learning and explaining to you. So in my view, that is a learning agent. A learning agent can learn from its past experience, or it has a learning capabilities. So it starts to act with the basic knowledge and then able to act and adapt automatically through learning. A learning agent has mainly four conceptual components. So what are the main four conceptual components that are present? Learning element. So it is responsible for making improvements by learning from environment. And next type of component is a critic. So what is this critic? A learning element takes feedback. Feedback from critic, which describes that how well the agent is doing with respect to a fixed performance standard. So you are giving the comments to me, right? I have the learning capabilities and I'm teaching to you by knowing, with the help of the past experience or maybe having the learning capabilities, I started reading you. So you're having one component like critics. You can be learning element takes feedback. I'm taking the feedbacks from you, okay, which describes that how well the agent is doing with respect to a fixed performance standard. And the performance element, it is responsible for selecting the external actions. And the another component is a problem generator. The problem generator, the component is responsible for suggesting actions that will lead to new informative experience. Okay, so hence the learning agents are able to learn, analyze performance and look for a new ways to improve the performance. So I'm having a learning agent. I'm the learning agent. Okay. A human body is its agent. I'm having the learning agent. Means I'm able to learn, analyze the performance and look for the new ways to improve the how to explain the subject. I want to improve the performance of my teaching ability. So see here this diagram. So the environment percepts the sensors. Now the sensors is having the performance standards. The performance standards is completely based on the critics that I'm getting, the feedbacks that I'm getting from the viewers. And I'm using these learning elements. Okay. And I'm reaching this learning goals. Okay. With the help of the learning elements, I can change the performance or can I can gain the knowledge and I will lead to the learning goals. So now the problem generator will experiment the performance. Now that performance elements will affect us, actuators and doing the actions. Now the environment will see the result. So whatever I am teaching the subject, okay. So based on your feedbacks, based on the current situation, I take in the artificial intelligence subject, that is the sensors. In my sensors, I take in the subject. Now with the help of all these performance standards, I take in some feedbacks and learning goals with all those things, my performance elements will be changed. Okay. And the result you can see on my video. Okay. So you have to tell whether I'm having that learning agent or not, or capability, learning agent capability or not, you need to be tell. So I hope you understand what are the types of artificial intelligence. Thank you.